Alright guys, so I'm currently just walking around. I'm just going for a walk for a little bit. Now I do know it is getting dark, and that's because I'm just, you know, yeah. But anyways, so I'm just going to be talking about some stuff. This is just going to be a chat video, I guess. So anyways, so let's start with the seasons of the weatherized. So the seasons, winter is got to be the most boring. Like, I put winter at last, fall at third, spring at second, and summer at first. Now, why do I put those into those placements? It's because winter is the most boring, because there's nothing going on. It's always cloudy and whatnot. And yes, I can get that there's a few flurries and whatnot, but it's still, you know, nothing. Like, there's little to no action in the winter. Now, fall is kind of not as boring, because, like, you know that October storm that we got in the fall? Yeah. Yeah, so there could be, you know, like, at least with the fall, I mean, there's still warm temperatures, and, you know, maybe some scattered isolated thunderstorms for us, sometimes. So that's why I put it at third. And the springtime, springtime is, like, the most rainiest month. Season. Like, the most rainiest. Like, the biggest example would be April. April is by far one of the most rainiest months ever. So, obviously, we would get, like, say, for example, that Ida video. Like, we got a flash flood watch due to significant heavy rainfall. Now, yes, that would make sense. Except it would not be a tropical storm hurricane. It would just be some ordinary storm. And, and that would mean that we would get, like, another example about rain is the flood warnings that we got in October. Like, not mid-October, the end of October. Like, we got those flood warnings due to heavy rain. And April is the biggest example of that. So, yeah. So that would mean that, yes, like, you know, the flood warnings. You know, we got multiple of them. So, yeah, so that's why I put spring at second. And then summer, obviously, is at first because of all the thunderstorms that we get. You know, we usually would get a lot of thunderstorms in the summer. You know, and then we would get, you know, the severe thunderstorm watch. And then we would get all these other severe thunderstorm warnings. And, you know, maybe possibly a few flash flood warnings. You know. So, like, yeah, that's pretty much all it is for most days. Because remember when I was first starting collecting radios, the first EAS alert happened on July 11th, that flash flood watch expansion. That alert was because of the ground being wet from water and rain and stuff. So, yeah, and when I experienced my first alert, I was very excited, because I was looking forward to seeing a lot of alerts, and that's what I experienced when I first started collecting radios, stuff like that. So, yeah, like, it's just, like, you know, like, And like the thunderstorms, it's just like, it's like there's thunderstorms for us every single day. My goodness, man. And I could not hear myself. Goodness, man, I cannot hear myself. Okay. So, what the heck? Anyways, as I was saying, the thunderstorms for our area. It's like we see thunderstorms every single day. I feel like we get so many thunderstorms every single day. Like, I feel like we get more thunderstorm days than sunny days in the summer. I feel like. But, like, if you look at my EAS Alert playlist, you would see that, you know, it starts with a flash flood watch expansion, and then it starts with like a severe thunderstorm watch, and then like a severe thunderstorm warning or something. Like, it's basically what the pattern is. It's like every few days or something, we would see, I don't know, like the thunderstorms are not that crazy. It's not like severe thunderstorms. It's just like scattered or something like that. So that's pretty much that. And and there's also these, and then there was the, I don't even know, something, but like these, there was like also these tropical storms. Before I started weather radio collecting, I would experience, you know, remember tropical storm Claudette, where I made multiple videos about her, and like the storm that was slowly coming towards us, like stuff like that. And it would be like, you know, like something. It would be just like that. And the tropical, and then there was Hurricane Ida, where I made a video in August making those flash flood watches from WXL37 on Channel 4 for the Mid-Hudson Valley. Yeah, those were three flash flood watches for New York, New Jersey, Pennsylvania, and Connecticut, I believe. And then came Hurricane Henry. Another hurricane that became a tropical storm because it was weakening. That storm was significant, and I made a video called I Missed a Flash Flood Watch. I don't know if it was because of Henry. I don't know if it was that Henry one. I really don't know. But, yeah. And then we ended off with more. But no, that's not it. We're still not done. Because in September, in the beginning of September, towards mid-September, there were more storms starting to come towards us. And then I started creating montages of EAS alerts, you know, just to be more easy instead of making a whole set, like, one video on that one and another video on that one. That this time I would be making montages of EAS alerts, catching as many EAS alerts that I can get. Like, it started in September 8th, where I made my first montage of getting the EAS alert. It started with a... Well, actually, before I made that video, we were getting warnings. Like, we were getting multiple severe thunderstorm warnings because of the storm. I tried to record these, but I just couldn't for... Like, I tried to record them, but all I would just do was just listen to them. And then when the severe thunderstorm watch came, that's when I started recording. And then it started with, and then a severe thunderstorm warning, and then another severe thunderstorm warning, and then a flash flood warning. And I made a little error where I accidentally said flash flood watch instead of flash flood warning. It's probably because of those hurricanes, like the flash flood watches. I get it mixed up with the flash flood warnings. Oh man, good times. And then came the other one, the other montage of the EAS alerts in September 15th, where it started with a severe thunderstorm watch, which I did not get. And then the next alert is where I started recording. Severe thunderstorm warning, flash flood warning, and then flash flood warning. And then my phone was dying on me, so I couldn't record any more alerts. So that's why I was only able to get not that many alerts, because my phone was dying on me, and the alerts just kept on going and going and going every time they were done, you know. So, yeah. And then there was the October 16th storm, and then that's where I had more radios. And then the severe thunderstorm watch, it was so crazy. Like, seriously, all my radios were like, that. And then, like, the only alerts that I ever gotten was the watch and only the one warning. That's all. Well, actually, I did catch one severe thunderstorm warning from WXL37, but that was just it. So... yeah, so that was all of that, and a few special weather statements as well. Alright, well, I'm almost home, so, might as well just go ahead and end the video here. So, yeah. So yeah, guys, so that's all I have for you guys. Now, I understand the flood warnings, but again, from heavy rain, so it's not that special. So yeah, guys, so I'm going to go ahead and end the video here. Hope you guys enjoyed it, even though it was only just me talking for most of the time. But I mean, like, that's all I can really get out of that. But in that case, I'm almost home, so might as well end the video before my phone dies, as it's just got a 10% battery notice. So I'll see you guys later. Bye-bye.